press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, today we are going to start the new chapter, that is
water.
Today's new chapter is water. When you hear about the word water, what will you come in your mind? Yes, you may think of drinking water, or you may think of some rivers, falls, lakes, some glaciers, as I said in the earlier classes, that is river of ice. Yes, you all will think about these kind of water bodies, right? And you know, when it rains, there will be a water in the mud, right? Yes, in that, when in your childhood, you guys have played the boat, you guys have made the boat and played in that mud water, right? Yes, you guys have made every kind of things in the water, like it may be a leaving the boat inside that water. And I think you have seen in the afternoon, the water which was present in the morning will evaporate, means it will go, it will not be there. What will happen to that water? Yes, as I already said, that water will evaporate. Okay, you know, water is a very essential thing in our life. We should conserve water more. Why should we conserve water more? I will explain that in a later classes. Now, I was explaining you about the water, when what you have seen in the early morning will not be the quantity of the water, what you have seen in the early morning will not be that much. Okay, let me give you an example. You put a bucket of water outside your house under the direct falling sunrise or under the sunlight. Then you observe that in afternoon, what you will see? You will see that some amount in a bucket, you should put some amount of water, okay? So this is a bucket, okay? You guys put some water up to 3/4 of the bucket, okay? Then you keep this bucket in the outside of your house under the direct sunlight. At afternoon, you observe. You will see that water will come here. Means water will be less in the bucket. Where does that remaining water will go? Had gone? Where this much amount of remaining water had gone? Huh? Surprise, right? Where will it go? Let me explain. The water which is present in this bucket, it will evaporate. This water, it will evaporate. Okay, it will evaporate to the atmosphere and it will form a vapor. By forming a vapor, it will evaporate. And that vapor, many vapors will condense. It condense in the atmosphere and they will cool down and they will condense. Okay, many kinds of vapor will be there. Many vapors will be there, right? What they will do, they will condense, they will form a cloud, they will form a cloud. When this cloud, which is very heavy to float in the water, it will fall down on the earth surface or any other water bodies in the form of rain or in the form of a sleet, anything. Okay, you guys understood? Let me explain it clearly. This water, what we see, it will, the water which is present, imagine this is the earth surface, there is a water, and this water will evaporate as a vapor. This water will evaporate in the atmosphere as a vapor. In the atmosphere, many such vapors will cool down and they will condense. Many such vapors, they will cool down and they will condense, and they form a cloud. Okay. Like way, the cloud which is very heavy in the atmosphere to float, it will fall as a rain or a mist, anything. Okay, it may be rain may fall on the earth surface or it may be on the sea water, anything. So this is how the water will evaporate and comes down. we have seen that water is very essential for our life, because only water can quench our thirst. Okay, when we are thirsty, anything except the water can't control our thirstiness. Only water can help us to get rid from the thirstiness, right? You know, even we can live without food for a days, but we cannot live without water for a days, because water is such a essential thing. You know how useful it is? Whatever the food you take inside, to digest that, we need water. If you don't drink water, and if you ate so much amount of food, what will happen? The food won't digest, because it needs some amount of water in order to digest. For the purpose, if we want to live healthily, we should drink more amount of water, because the water will remove all the waste from our body. So water plays a major role in every life on the earth. It may be either plant or it may be animal. For every living thing, water is very essential. Okay, you have seen water in many kinds, that it may be in the form of lake, or it may be in the form of ponds, or it may be in the form of some kind of water bodies, right? You have seen many kind of water. Then now we will going to see that, as I said already, okay, the process by which this water will change its form from one another to another, one to another form, and it will transfer from atmosphere to the, it will transfer from land to atmosphere, from atmosphere to ocean surfaces. This process is known as water cycle. Let me explain the process of water cycle. Water cycle. Now, CLE. Okay. Now we have seen uses of water, why it is essential and how it will evaporate, right? This water cycle means the form which is means the water which change its form from one to another, from and it will evaporate from land to earth's atmosphere, and then coming back from atmosphere to oceanic surfaces as rain. Is this process is known as water cycle. Let me explain it with the help of a diagram, okay, so that you guys will understand it clearly. Let me write a diagram here. These are the clouds. These are the clouds. Okay. And this is the mountain. This is the mountain. And this is the water body. This is the water bodies. The water which is present on these water bodies, the water which is present on these water bodies, and the water which is present in the land surface as well, will evaporate. Okay, it will evaporate because of the high amount of sun rays. It will evaporate, okay, because of the sun rays heat, it will absorb the water. So the water from the oceanic surfaces or from the land surfaces, it will evaporate from the land surface or earth surface. Then after evaporation, this will go in the atmosphere, and those evaporated particles, that are vapor, what we call it as vapor, those vapors will cool down and they will condense and they will form a cloud. Okay, the water particles which are present in the water surface, or it may be on the land, they will evaporate due to the sun's heat, and they will form a vapor in the atmosphere. Again, those vapors will cool down and they will form the clouds in the atmosphere. Okay, they will form a clouds in the atmosphere. When this cloud is very much heavy to float in the atmosphere, okay, when it is very much heavy to float in the atmosphere, it will form as a rain or precipitate, or it will form as a water again to a land surface or to a water bodies. Okay, this is the water cycle. Here you can see the water which is present in a liquid form, it has changed to a vapor form. Okay, and then it has changed the solid form, a cloud. Okay, again it become a liquid or a droplet and it came into a land surface. So from here to here it had changed many forms. The first form was liquid form, then to a vapor form, then to a solid form, then to again to a liquid form. So such kind of change, such kind of changes in the form of a water from the land surfaces, and when it goes to atmosphere again it may come to a land surfaces or a water bodies, this is known as water cycle. So this is why we are going to get the water, right? The water which is present on the earth's surface will evaporate in the form of vapor because of the sun rays. Okay, it will evaporate because of the sun rays falling on the water bodies. These evaporated water will cool down in the atmosphere and it will condense and this form a cloud. Okay, this form clouds here. When these clouds become heavy in the atmosphere, they will fall on the mountain or it may be a land surface or it may be a water bodies. Like this, water circulates. Okay, water from here again we are going to get here because of the water cycle, right? This is about the water cycle. Till now you have seen that water is very essential for our life, and how does the water come from where does the water come from? The water which is present on the earth's surface will cycle like this, will change its form from one to another form, and it will again be available for us like this. So this is about the water cycle. Then we will move on to a next topic, that is, before that let me tell you some point about this water. You know, our earth is a terranium. You know what is meant by terranium? Terranium means it is artificial enclosure. Either it is an artificial enclosure where we can plant trees or plants. Okay, our earth has become like that. On the earth we can plant many amount of plants, right? So it has become some kind of terranium. Terranium is artificial enclosure where plants have grown. That is known as terranium. So we are going to grow the plants on the land surface. That is why plant land surface or earth surface is also called as a terranium. Understood? This is about the point terranium. The next, the water which is existed in the centuries ago, which was existed on 100 years ago in our earth surface, is still remaining. Because how it is still remaining from that surface, from that time to now, you will have a doubt, right? How will the water remain from the long time back ago, from that time to till now? Because of the water cycle. You have seen that this water will move from one form to another form and come again to a oceanic or a land surface. Because of this, the water which was present 100 years ago is still remaining on our earth surface till now. Okay, and the water which is used to irrigate a fields in the Haryana or it may be in Davangere, it can be found in the Amazon rivers, because the water which is present on the earth surface, it will evaporate and it will condense there and it will form a clouds and then it will become a rain and it will fall down. The water which is evaporated from Davangere, okay, it may evaporate in form of cloud. this cloud may rain on the Amazon River or it may rain on the other some parts like Mangalore in Karnataka. Okay, like that, it may rain anywhere, right? But the water which was taken from Davangere, right? You can understand what I'm telling. So the water, because of this water cycle, the water is the water from the one place can be seen in the another place. This is the point they are going to say in the textbook. Okay, you can see because of the water cycle, we can see the water from one place to another place. Okay, this is about the water cycle. Then the major source of fresh waters are rivers, it may be estuaries, or it may be lake, or it may be ponds, or it may be glaciers. As I said, ice rivers, glaciers, or ice rivers. See, a water cycle. The pure water or a fresh water is seen in the glaciers or rivers. Or it may be estuaries, or it may be ponds, etc. This water, the fresh water, can be seen in the glaciers, rivers, estuaries, ponds, anything. Okay, this is about the fresh water. Then we will see the ocean bodies. How those ocean what those ocean body contain what type of water? These ocean bodies contain a salty water. Why we call them a salty water? Because water which is present in the ocean contains salt. It may be sodium chloride, the common salt which you guys use for the food purpose. That salt is present in the water which is present in the ocean surfaces. That we call as salty water which is present in the oceanic surfaces. So you guys have known that there are two kinds, that is fresh water water bodies and the salty water water bodies. You know that we can't drink the salt water, right? You guys can go and try it in the home. You can drink plain water or a fresh water up to a one bottle full. You can drink one bottle full of plain or a fresh water, but you can't drink a salty water, right? But what happens is that our earth, it is made up of 3/4 of our earth, it is made up of water. But still we are fighting for water. There is a water scarcity in our earth. Why is that? Let me tell you. You take our earth as a, this is our earth. Okay, let me write it round. This is our earth. Let me divide this four parts. Okay, this part and this part, all these three parts means 3/4 of the earth, it is fully covered with the water. But only 1% is land. But still we fight for water, and there is this much water scarcity. Why is that? Because the more amount of water is a salty water which we cannot drink. Only few percent of the water which is present on the earth's surface is a fresh water or a drinkable water. Rest is a salty water which we cannot drink. That is why we fight with each other for the purpose of water. People say that there may happen a world war because of the water scarcity. So we have to conserve our water. Let me give the distribution percentage of the water so that you guys can understand clearly how much percentage of water is present in the earth surface, and in that how much amount of salt water is there and how much amount of fresh water is there. Let me write it. The distribution of water bodies distribution of water bodies. The total water bodies which are present on the earth's surface, they are distributed into different percentages. Let me write them. Oceans, they are about 97.3%. In the total 100%, about 97.3% is of ocean water, which is a salty water. Which is not useful for the drinking purpose. Understood, guys? Yes. See, only about 2.7% remaining water whole earth should use for the drinking purpose. You can assume here, only within this little amount of water, whole earth people should satisfy their thirst. Can you imagine how much less water we have to drink? This is why we should conserve the water for the future generation. You know, at this generation, in our generation, we will drink the water which is available for us. What about the future generation? Right, we should think about them, right? That is why we have to conserve the water. How should we conserve the water? See, if you guys see in your local areas, if there any taps are running, you should go on off that tap, and you should not waste the water which is used to wash the vegetables. Instead of that, you should give that water to a plants. There how you can conserve the water without wasting. So the point is, how can we conserve the water means we should minimize the waste, or we should not waste the water, because water is a precious resource for our life process. Because we want to, our ancestors, they have gifted us a wonderful planet which contain a water for drinking purpose. Since that, we have since from the long time we are enjoying the resources. This should be continued to our future generation. We should not make our future generation to suffer from the lack of water. That is why we have to give our future generation water. That is why we have to conserve water. How will you conserve the water? Whenever you see the tap which is running, you will go and off the tap. And whenever you see that the water is wasted heavily, you will go and tell them not to waste the water. And you should tell them what are the consequences of the wasting water. Okay, understood, guys? Yes, you should know that water is a very essential resource and it is very less to use. That is why we should conserve the water. So, this is about the ocean. Around 97.3% of water is present in the ocean, but it is waste water because that is salty water. We cannot drink that. That is why. And the rest is ice caps. In the form of ice caps, there is 2% of water. Okay. And in the groundwater is about 0.68%, and the fresh water in the lakes, it is about 0.009%, and inland seas and salt lakes, that is about 0.009%. In the atmosphere, we have 0.0019%. And in the rivers, let me write it here so that you guys can see. Can you see? Okay. In the rivers, we have about 0.0001%. these whole thing except the ocean rest all are fresh waters. But in this fresh water also, in the ice caps, which is in the form of ice, we cannot use that water, right? So 2% of water is lost. And groundwater, which is inside the ground, we cannot use the groundwater for the drinking purpose. Like that, 0.6% water is lost, and fresh water in the lakes, only we can use 0.009% of water for the whole earth. And salt lakes, we cannot use. In the atmosphere, it is about 0.001.19%. Yes, it is also available for us, because when it comes as a rain on the earth surface, we can use. Or if that water goes inside the sea, means we cannot use. So that is not much usable. In the rivers, it is 0.001%. It is usable for us. Okay, see, in the total 100%, nearly 97.3% is covered by the ocean, which is a salt water. Only 2.7% left in that. In the 2.7%, we only have 0.68% as well as 0.001% for the drinking purpose. See how much less amount of water we are having for the drinking purpose. This is why we have to save the water. See, let me show with the diagram. Imagine this is a water. Okay, in that whole, this 97%, it is covered by salt water, and only this amount of water is available for us to a drinking purpose. I think so. You guys cannot see it clearly. Let me draw it a bigger water circle. Imagine this is a water body. In that, whole 97.3% is lake. Okay. This everything is, ocean. Ocean. That is 97.3%. We cannot use this water for the drinking purpose because it contains a sodium chloride, that is salt. Okay, because of that, we cannot use this water for the drinking purpose. But the water which is available for us to drink is only this much. That is 0.001 and 0.009%. Only this much water is available for us to drink. Then imagine in this much water, whole earth, we are only present in a state. In the whole India, there are so many states. And this India, it is present in a big continent, Asia. Like that, there are six more continents. So imagine, there are so much of people on this earth surface who want to drink. And those every people, they are depending upon this only little amount of water. This is why we should conserve the water. We should not waste the water. If we waste the water, we will lose this resource. Only this much is there for us, and we will lose this also. Like this, we will lose everything. And in the future generation, we have water for a drinking purpose. Okay. This is about the distribution of water. Now we will see that the topic is salinity. As I said, the ocean water is very it contains very salt, means it is a saline water. What do you mean by salinity? Salinity means the amount of salt which is present in a water is known as salinity. The amount of salt in grams which is present in 1,000 liter or 1,000 gram of water is known as salinity. And as I said already, this salinity is because of the sodium chloride or a salt, common salt, which you use for a cooking purpose. This is about the salinity. Then we will see the Dead Sea, which is present in the where it is present? Yes, it is present in the Israel, right? This Dead Sea, it is present in the Israel. It contains about 340 grams of salt per liter of water. See, the Dead Sea, which is present in the Israel, it contains 340 grams per liter of water. See how much high amount of salt it is, right? This Dead Sea contains this much of water. Because of the high amount of salt in the water, the swimmers, they cannot swim in that. They will float because of the heavy salt in it. Because of the heavy salt, any other kind of works are not allowed, okay? Because they will affect the work efficiency. So, this is about the Dead Sea. Then, we will see the other topic. There is an activity in your textbook. Let me read that or let me explain it. You can take a bucket of water. Okay, you guys can take a bucket of water. You take out the 4 to 5 spoons in it. Okay, let me explain it with a diagram. This is a bucket. Okay, this is a bucket. You guys keep water up to here in the bucket and again take out some 4 to 5 spoons. 4 to 5 spoon of water. Why we are doing this activity means the water which is remaining in the bucket after taking out the 4 to 5 spoons, this water is salty water, which is not suitable for drinking purpose. See, there is bucket of water on the earth surface, but there is much amount of water on the earth surface, but we cannot use it because the water is salt water. The 4 to 5 spoon of water which we took out of the bucket is a fresh water. Only we can drink this 4 to 5 spoon of water. Imagine, within the 4 to 5 spoon of water, we should satisfy the thirst of whole earth people, right? There is a bucket of water, but it is not useful. Only 4 to 5 spoons are useful for the humankind. That is why we have to save the water. Understood? Yes. And let me give you another point, that is World Water Day. World Water Day, this is celebrated on 22nd of March. Okay, the World Water Day, it is celebrated on the 22nd of March. Why we'll celebrate this kind of days? Because in order to educate the people about the resource, water resource, in order to educate them that not to waste the water, okay? So, you guys, you children are educated now. You know everything about the water and how much it is there on the earth surface and how much we use for our surface, right? So, you should know about the water now. You guys, what you should now? You should go to your home and you should tell your mother not to waste the water. You should tell everyone who wastes the water simply. And you should tell them not to waste the water because we have to conserve it for our future generation. Or it may be we have to conserve it for ourselves. Who knows? Water may end up, whole available water may end up within this generation itself. That is why we have to conserve water for our sake. Okay? This is how it happens. Okay, this is about the water. Okay, we will discuss again or we will analyze today's topic once again. Till now, we have seen about the water. As you can see, water means whenever you hear the word water, you will think about the waterfalls. Okay, Shimoga waterfall, Jokh Falls. Yes, you will think about the waterfalls or rivers or flood, or it may be lakes, anything, or it may be tap water which is flowing in a tap, right? This is that is water. This water is very essential resource for our life because it will satisfy, it will quench our thirst. Okay, that is why water is very essential. Without water, we cannot live on this earth. Water is very essential to our mankind. And in the water, we can play. We will get much amount of enjoyment in the water, right? Yes. And this water, how will that come to on the earth's surface? The water which is present on the earth's surface will get evaporated because of the sun rays falling on the water. And that water will evaporate and form a vapor in the atmosphere. Those vapor, after cooling down, they condense and they form a cloud. Okay, those clouds will become very heavy in the meantime, and there will be a very difficulty to float those clouds in the atmosphere. That is why those clouds will fall on the earth's surface in the form of rain. Okay, they will form on the earth's surface or the water bodies in the form of rain. This is known as water cycle. Water cycle means change of the water from one form to another form. Change of the water from one to another form. It may be evaporation from the earth's surface to atmosphere and again coming back to earth's surface as a form of rain. This is known as water cycle. And we have seen that distribution of water means how much percent of water is present in the oceans and how much amount of water is present in the fresh water and how much amount we can use for our drinking purpose. Everything we have seen. Okay, right. And we have seen that about the some topics that Dead Sea and all. Dead Sea contain about 340 gram of salt in it, and that is why it is very difficult to float in it. It is difficult to do works in it. And we have seen that what else we have seen in this topic is we have seen about the what is meant by salinity. It is amount of salt present in the water, and we have seen that the fresh water is present in the estuaries, lakes, glaciers, ponds and the rivers, etc. And these are the things we have seen about the water. In the future classes we will see about the different topics or the rest topics in the water lesson. So this is about the today's lesson. If you have any doubt, you can clarify with me. Thank you.